Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we will discuss about the need of the tuned amplifier and types of tuned circuits, then the tuned circuit which we use in amplifier, the frequency response and the sharpness of the curve. In our day-to-day life, we use FM radio. In FM radio, when we select particular channel, at that time we are actually selecting a particular frequency and we reject the other frequencies. It's called as a tuning. And if that concept is used in amplifier, then that amplifier is called as a tuned amplifier. So tuned amplifier is an amplifier which will select the desired frequency and reject the other unwanted signal. For example, radio and TV station transmits the frequencies, that is 30 kHz to 300 MHz, which is audio frequency range. So TV and the radio receiver needs to pick the selected frequency while rejecting the other frequencies. Now this process cannot be done by the normal amplifiers like small signal amplifiers or multi-stage amplifier, because it provides the wide frequency response, that is the voltage gain is constant for the wide frequency range. It amplifies all the frequencies well, so we cannot use these amplifiers for selecting the particular frequency. Tuned circuit is a circuit which will select the particular signal and reject the other frequencies, and that tuned circuit is used along with the transistor, is known as a tuned voltage amplifier. So in tuned voltage amplifier or tuned amplifier, it serves two purposes. The first one is select the desired frequency, and the second one is amplify the signal up to the required voltage level. There are two types of tuned circuit. One is series tuned circuit and parallel tuned circuit. In series tuned circuit, R, L and C are connected in series, to which we are applying the AC input signal. And in parallel tuned circuit, resistor R and L are connected in series and capacitor is connected in parallel. To this circuit, we are applying the AC input signal. Now in tuned amplifier, we are using parallel tuned circuit where the R represents the coil resistance, and at one particular frequency, the XL, that is inductive reactance, is equal to the capacitive reactance. So XL is equal to XC, and at that frequency the resonance occurs, that means the maximum amplification appears at that particular frequency. So XL is equal to 2 pi FL and XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. So at resonant frequency, that is we will mark it as F0 square, is equal to 1 upon 4 pi square L into C. So we will get the resonant frequency is 1 upon 2 pi under root LC. So at this frequency, we will get the maximum amplification, and for the other frequencies, we will get the minimum amplification. This is the diagram of bandwidth of the parallel tuned circuit. It is the graph of frequency versus impedance. We can see that at the resonant frequency, the impedance is maximum. The bandwidth of this tuned circuit lies between A and B, where the impedance is 1 upon root 2 of maximum impedance or 0.707 of maximum impedance value. The bandwidth of this tuned circuit is given as bandwidth is equal to, it is the difference between the two frequencies, that is FH minus FL. The parallel tuned circuit provides the same amplification for the frequencies which lies between A and B. So these points are basically called as half power points. So power required for producing the impedance will be half of the maximum power. So bandwidth here is FH minus FL. It gives the useful frequency range. The resonance curve should be as sharp as possible, because when it is sharp, it provides the selectivity. The sharpness of the curve is defined as, it is the ratio of the bandwidth to the resonant frequency. Bandwidth is given as the difference between the high frequency and low frequency, and the resonant frequency is denoted as F0, which is equal to 1 upon Q. Now Q is called as a quality factor. Quality factor is defined as the ratio of inductive reactance to the resistance. XL can be given as 2 pi FL divided by R. The term quality factor is also important in tuned amplifier, because if the quality factor is high, that means the selectivity is high. If the quality factor is low, that means the circuit is less selective. Q factor also depends upon the resistance. As the resistance increases, the quality factor decreases. So we will get three graphs. If the resistance is low, then we will get the high quality factor, and that circuit is highly selective. That means it selects the desired frequency and rejects the other signals. If the resistance increases, then the quality factor decreases. That means the circuit is having less selectivity because of less value of Q and more value of R. So quality factor is important in the selection of the tuned amplifier. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with eKeeda and subscribe to eKeeda.